are our lifestyle. Please don't forget. All my friends are heathens, taking slow. Hello, boys, girls, and all those in between. My name is JD the Train Spotter, and welcome to episode 6 of JDPlays OMSI 2. Today we are here in the Solaris Urbino 12 in the lovely green Daytran Express livery. I do love this livery on this train, this repaint. We are running the Route 100, and people are being annoying and messaging me on Facebook. We are doing the Route 100. We're going from here at Reymount Rail Station to Warren Avenue. We're replacing that bus. So let's set the bus up. This one is quite a pain in the arse to drive, but also a pleasant one to drive. So what we do is leave it in neutral, turn the engine on, release the parking brake, put it into drive. Hold the brake down. Hear that noise. Turn it into drive, leave it there, put the parking brake back on, and set the bus up to go. So we are running the Route 100. 100-00 on the route down to Daytonford. Let's skip time forward 9 minutes, so we need to go 30, give ourselves a minute to work with. So as you see, it says Daytonford Warren Avenue. The passengers start working, so we'll just drive up to this and open the doors. So this bus is a very pleasant one to drive.
Man, we must be in Antarctica or something. It's so cold on this goddamn bus.
I didn't do the temperature, so we just turn that up.
Do you do two-way tickets?
Well, the heat's on. So one thing to know about this bus is the layout of the dash is very similar to that in the Mercedes-Benz Citaro. It's sort of the modern bus layout. So it's basically identical. It has a Solaris symbol there, a few other smaller different layouts to it. Let's turn on Shift L and 7, 8, 9. 7 does nothing on these buses. Lovely interior on these things, I will say. Let me just show you. See, it's got a lovely green based interior. Very pleasant. So this is one of the, as I was saying in the previous video, we are driving one of the express routes today. This is Route 100, it goes all the way from Reymount Rail Station, which is quite far off the map, into Warren Avenue. There is actually, when you download this map, there is actually a documentation that comes with it where you can see, can I not, this is kind of in the way, like, let's just go. Yeah. And it gives you documentation which includes a route map so you can see where the routes go to and from. There's also a thing that tells you it as well.
Welcome aboard Daytran Express Line 100 to Daytonford. Customers are reminded this is a limited stop service. Please ensure you are traveling to stops in Reymount, West Rosewood, Daytonford Rail Station, or Daytonford Warren Avenue only. The first stop is Reymount Rise.
Now you can see, as I said in a previous video on Daytonford, the announcements on this map are much more pleasant and detailed than other maps in the game, especially freeware maps. Lovely and detailed, very American-like, to put it nicely, is that it goes into proper detail and fully tells you. It's not just like the London iBus system, which just tells you the next stop. Very pleasant. So yeah, thoroughly nice, thoroughly enjoyable to listen to. And that man gets passengers all the time, by the way. No matter how you take it, they get annoyed at you. Don't know what it is. There's something in the map that's bugged, I think. Can I go forward a bit more? Thank you.
Hey there, how you do?
But yeah, this is a very pleasant one to drive, this bus.
Hey there, how you do?
Originally, when they made it, the bus was nothing nailed, but they released an update recently which added the horn, fixed a few little bugs, and then it took out the horn function. But you can turn that on, you just have to, hang on. You just get rid of the wheel, press that button, and then obviously it does it. But it automatically, see what it does is when you stop, it turns on the bus stop brake, so it's no longer an automatic kneeling function. You have to do it manually now, which is a small pain because it's nice in like certain maps to have the kneeling. Oops, I didn't really check that.
Man alive, is this guy serious?
Shut
That's
up.
A bad, bad driver.
Next stop is Belmont Drive.
I'm getting off as soon as I can.
Well, you're not. You're not pressing the bell.
Did this guy get his license to drive
his goddamn
bus?
I'm not doing anything, by the way.
Where did you know what he's doing?
Maps really buggy for passengers, so ignore the passenger complaints, help them on. genuine. Previous video they would have been because I drove like a bit differently. Driving very calmly this time. You kind of have to in the Solaris. It sort of forces you to drive carefully because it makes you wait to open the doors. All of that kind of stuff. It makes you drive quite patiently because it doesn't have a great braking system. They're good, but they're like air brakes, so they take a while to apply, and once you hit the max braking, it takes a long time to make a difference. So if I show you what I mean, like if I hit the brake now, see it slowly applies, and it takes a long time to make a difference. So, yeah, you just be careful with this bus when driving it. And it's deliberately done so that it really affects passengers. It's a genuine thing in real life, like modern buses now. When a bus, I need to keep checking when I do these bets.
The next stop is Lake Road. Customers for Reymount Beach should exit here.
It's always a busy bus stop, this one.
Hey there, give me a single.
As I was trying to say, yeah, and a lot of modern buses, especially in the new Gemini 3s, in London, for example, when the bus brakes quite challengingly because of whatever reason it has to, it really makes a difference. Even short soft braking is really hard on the passenger, especially when you're standing. And I think that's kind of the aim with these buses.
All right.
It sort of forces you to drive quite religiously, I guess you could say. Sort of like James May, Top Gear. Or, sorry, Grand Tour now.
The next stop is Ridge Road.
This was actually when I downloaded this map for the first time. It's about a year ago now. It must have been about a year ago, yeah, that I started playing this map for the first time. The first map route I did was this, the Route 100, from Reymount to Warren Avenue. And I noticed that it's really scenic at the beginning bit here. There's lovely bits of the beach, there's the forest. Really pleasant route to drive along. But it does sort of show that the route is quite old now, and it uses a lot of assets, like the houses you can see, they're all from, when you compare it to Cotterell now, they are all just from like the default game. Like Cotterell is all custom assets by the UK design team. That was a terrible stop. But anyway, yeah, they're all like custom assets from the design team, custom splines, that's the word I'm looking for. From the UK design team, even the roads, down to the roads,
just
are custom, like the pavements.
Thanks, man.
Hi.
With this, the road texture itself is changed. As you can see, it's quite American. It's got the solid yellow line in the middle and the blacker tarmac on the outside. But in general, the pavements themselves, they're just from the default game. And, won't get into the mic, something fell down my desk. But in general, I think that was Noble Street, by the way. I haven't even been saying station names, stop names, have I? Anyway.
The next stop is Noble Street.
Mine. Oh, the next Noble Street. Can you not lag these games? So we are soon approaching the motorway, but yeah, you can sort of see the assets are just sort of the default ones. The splines are sort of the default ones, but slightly tweaked, but it is still very pleasant. So this is the area where you approach. Just be careful on this bit, you don't drive too fast, because either you slam into, or in my case, drive through this wall, because I don't have collisions on. Really cool, this bit. Look, you go right across the cliff face. You get a lovely view out to that bay. Just staggering, like the effort that went into this. Although that hill could be done a little bit better, but you know what? I'm not going to sit here slating this map because I enjoy it. It's a fun route, and I'm not expecting full realism. It's a bus simulator. It's not a bus life. It's not real life. It's not a bus drive. It's not being a bus driver. This is something that's quite cool on this map. Is the roundabouts like this actually have traffic lights on them? And similar to how you actually get this in England sometimes, where there's traffic lights where there's a crossing.
Oh,
and when you come around the curve,
that's a bad, bad driver.
And when you come around the roundabout and you get out to your exit, if the light's red, you have to wait for pedestrians to cross. So it's quite cool and realistic. Something I know about this is a little wheelchair sign has appeared. I think on a Solaris itself in real life, that's to signify a buggy is requested to leave the bus. What you do for this is just turn on this buggy symbol here, something that isn't on the Sitara, but it is on the Solaris. Just turn that on, it will get rid of it, because it does just sort of stay on if you don't do that. It doesn't really have an effect on anything, it's just always there on. So remember to turn that on when that comes up, because it can be annoying having the buggy symbol there, because you can sort of think it's the stopping sign if you're at a glance, if you're not concentrating fully. And then stopping, and then no one wants to get off, and you're just wasting your time. So yeah, remember that. I always make sure I do. So what we're doing here, we approaching the centre of Reymount, and then we go out from Reymount to the motorway. Noble Street is on the corner here, then there's a nice little sort of shopping place, and then it's the motorway if I remember rightly, but don't quote me to that, it's been a while since I drove this. We are getting people to get off here as well.
Alright.
You see again, this has automatic rear doors, so they will open and close once passengers have, so in a minute now you'll see the rear doors will now close. But we're going to just quickly turn on the buggy symbol, because it will mark as a stop at all times, then turn that off. So that can also be used to open the doors manually. So if you want the rear doors to open manually, you just click that button there. There we go. Right, so our next stop is...
The next stop is West Rosewood.
West Rosewood, which is again this nice shopping area thing where it's like in the middle of the shopping area. It's quite nice, this bit, actually. I like this stop a lot.
Oh my God. Is this guy serious?
Sorry,
that's
that
a
yellow.
bad
I didn't see the yellow, so sort of panicked there. Oh, that stop. So we are quite near to full, but there is no little completo sign, which there was on the 0405, so we can't mark that as true, but we might have stopped picking up passengers soon. Look, actually, how many seats are there? Is there any seats there? There's a seat there. There's one at the back. There's a few at the back. Again, the interior is really nice on this. I like this interior. That reminds me of the Transdev seats they had before they went out. That they have on the Gemini 2s, but in green instead of red. Are we looking to go soon? Yeah, we are. That light up there was changing green. Red. Sorry. Yeah, there it is. There as well. So just pull into here, turn this temperature thing down. I'll stop before I do.
How you do?
Hiya.
Again, left the temperature on a bit too long. I always get it wrong with the temperature.
Thanks, man.
I'm terrible at keeping
just give me
right
a
D. I've already
Thanks,
would be alright in real life, but in this game I'm terrible at it.
Hiya.
If I ever became a bus driver, which I wouldn't, because
one
great job and all. And I'm not saying there's anything
great.
Wrong with it.
Thanks.
If I had to, I would, but I really want to work in IT, so.
Hello there. One way.
Just playing around with that. So you can open the cab door on this one.
One way.
And it is quite well open, actually.
Thank
it's
you.
Just one that opens and makes sense. Similar to the
Hello,
the
you.
City bus, but as you can see, it's literally just
Return,
a.
Please.
So
Thank
if I
you.
Let it go, it's just literally a click and drag, and then you close it. Obviously with the city bus, slightly Enviro, you've got a click, little clicky thing to open it, so it locks on the inside. I'm sure this has a lock on the inside in real life, like, that you can't do in the game.
The next stop is Rose Creek Avenue.
Oh, thank you. Terrible turning, but that's fine. Not rushing because we have got a red. There we go. But yeah, I think the Solaris is really enjoyable to use. It's very well made. Like the Sitaro and the MAN buses, it's very well modeled. There's no skimmed textures anywhere on the bus. Ooh, blimey. Passengers decided to unload the textures, but there's no skimmed textures anywhere on the bus. Like the Sitaro, and the MANs obviously they come with the game, but like the Sitaro, there isn't any skim textures, and the MB405, there's nothing like, you know, no flat coloured textures, it's all very well shown with textures like, you know, grainy colours. Wrong button, there you go. Press the horn instead of the flash. Oops. I'm mounting the curb, aren't I? Oh no. Never mind. There we go, right.
Oh, doing?
This is Rose Creek Avenue. do that so I can see the rear doors. There we go. Alright, so we're now 3 minutes late, so let's catch up a bit. I think that's turning, I'm not sure. No, it's straight. I'll just hope and pray, shall I? Yeah, so we now...
May I have your attention, please? We will soon be joining the highway towards Daytonford. The bus will be traveling at high speed. For your comfort and safety, please ensure that you are seated comfortably or holding firmly onto one of the handrails. If you have large or heavy bags, please ensure they are secure in the bag of tracks. Thank you.
I just wanted to let you see that, hear that announcement, so I sort of stopped accelerating. But yeah, I quite like that announcement. It's very, very nice. We don't get that in England if the bus takes them from the highway. They just either the bus driver announces it or that's it, really.
Man alive, is this guy serious? That's a bad, bad driver.
Oops. Didn't slow down quite quick enough there. Just the reverse. There we go. As close as we can get. Pretty crap performance in terms of turning on that part, well, braking, sorry, in that area, but that's fine. Okay, and now we are on the highway. So, full speed ahead. Whilst keeping an eye on the temperature this time. So this is quite the plain bit of the journey. It's just a straight run down the highway, and then it's a few extra stops in Daytonford. So I'll just get into here. In the previous episode, and I've said multiple times, Train Sim is making its way on the channel. Hopefully getting it done by the Easter holidays. What I'm going to do to myself, say to myself, is if by the last half term, weekend of the half term, holidays, Easter holidays, I haven't got the scenario finished I wanted to do originally, then I will obviously do a different scenario. So recommendations that I get before then I might do instead, so you never know. You never know what's going to be played at that point. But yeah, got about 3 weeks till the end of the holidays. It's next week. Next Friday is the last day of term, and then it's the Easter holidays. And at that point, if I'm not, I should be starting to work on the scenario towards the end of the holidays. I'm obviously at my mum's for most of the holidays, but towards the end I'll work on it a bit. There is another bus. Let's see what it is by pressing P and going into F4 mode. Be a bit quieter now. In terms of the game, it is it's a fellow 100. It's running. Oh, it's an MB0405. That's quite nice actually. That's a hashtag go past. There we go. Yeah, so again, we don't know what scenario could be. It could be anything at this point, but I do hope to make it the one I was working on. So yeah, that will be coming soon. I'm definitely going to run the reskin version, as I said before. Have some 802s running. I don't like the 802s and all that, but we will have them running just because it makes it more authentic for 2024. As I said, it was based in the future. We're in the wrong lane. Doesn't mean we're doing it over the speed limit because that car is going slower than us, but it's fine. We're trying to get there. Actually, we could slow down to the speed limit. What is the speed limit? I don't even know. We'll get behind a car and then we'll find out. Thank you. Also, if you guys would like to see some open TTD, by all means, do feel free to ask. I will happily do that for you guys. Yeah. I don't know what I'll do for it though. I'll probably do like a world from scratch sort of thing. Not sure. I'll probably just start afresh. I don't know what I'd do. I'll probably just show you firstly my world I was working on recently. I don't know why I drove into that car like that. And then probably have a go at doing one from like legit, showing you guys the best way to make money in the game. The thing of OpenTTD, it is a great game. It's thoroughly enjoyable, but without the certain settings turned on, it's sort of, you play for a long time, get so much money coming in, you don't know what to do with it, and then just sort of running out of things to do and having to quit that world and start another one. And I guess that's how the game works, but yeah. I'm gonna eat some, get kind of chunky here, because I'm a bit hungry. Love a good kick cut. Alright, so we are turning off here. Oh, we're not. Never mind. Blimey. Long time on the motorway. Cut us up, I guess. I reckon it's 60 these cars are doing, but we are pulling off up ahead, so no need to rush about now. Doing? You're driving like you're drunk. I'm trying to overtake. No, I'm not. The road. Oh. Give him a little thank you. Let us go, which is nice. I'm not the center of the universe. Sorry, I've got that new Linkin Park song stuck in my head. Actually, speaking of that, let's talk about music. Linkin Park, they made a new song. It's called Heavy. It features this Kiara person. Kiara? I don't know how to pronounce her name. And it's like Linkin Park. We don't know what they're like. Hang on.
The next stop is Daytonford Station. Transfer here for
road services. So if you don't know what their music is like, it sort of evolves over time, so they've gone from like heavy metal to angst to EDM to loads of different things. And this time, they decided to do pop. Now, when you think pop, you think Little Mix, you think Half Naked Women, you think rubbish crap lyrics where they're just crying about a breakup and they mean nothing. But funnily enough, Linkin Park didn't do that. They did rock, they did pop, but it came out well. I think they did pop really well, and the lyrics mean something. It's about like depression and stuff. It's really good. Give me one moment, please. Apologies about that one. Just had to take a phone call. Yeah, just Right, so we are now making our way to the next one, Daytonford Rail Station. I had to take a phone call because it was my mum and it is quite important. So, yes. It's regarding a few things, including booking tickets for Reading and all that. But it also means that I've now planned another trip, so there'll be another video you will probably have seen before this one I've had, that you most likely will have, that came out of nowhere. Yay! Be something a bit different, probably a one-off, but something different. So. That was a terrible journey. You always have to swing wide on the bus, because if you don't swing wide, then a car will screw you in. And if you do it on going the way closest where the curb is, you always skim the curb, so, yeah. Anyway, moving swiftly on, let's continue to the next stop, as I said before. Yeah, So, the Solaris actually won't have been used before, like, 2012, and the game, timing game is 2007, but... I'm using this video more to show off the Solaris and the livery, not so much keep to realism. Normally I would keep to realism, and I think in future, once we've done a few showing off stuff, I will do like the sort of realism things and all that. It's a 30... oh jeez. I think that's been miles per hour actually, because it's the US, so that's 50 kilometers, so we'll get onto that. Keep our distance from these cars, because the AI in this game brakes like instantaneously, so gotta be careful of them. They use like full brakes, you'll see in a sec. Never mind, they're not braking now. Well, they're not. Straight for it. There you go. Again, braking almost fully. Around that bend, because you have to take the bend slowly. But I guess it is AI, so they're just programmed, they're not actually controlled by anyone, so it's understandable. Oh, blimey, is this where we're stopping? How long the traffic jam? Oh my god, this traffic jam is long. Jeez Louise. And I know the rail station's only like over there, I believe. Right, anyway, moving on. We'll just wait. Ugh. Right, the traffic is moving a lot now, which is good. That's not gone too far though. I forgot I was talking about before on my phone call, so what was it? My mind struck a blank. What was I talking about before the phone call? OpenTTD, that was it. I think for open TTD, if I bring it to the channel, I'll probably do sort of a just a playthrough of the best way to make money, and then show you what it's like progressing through the game. And then once it gets sort of depleted, then we'll stop. So we'll look into that once we start it. Of course, JDPlays isn't just for you guys to watch playing like let's plays of the game, but also to sort of introduce you to new games, so OpenTTD, OMSI, Train Sim, stuff like that. You know, games that, I mean, Train Sim most of you probably would have played, OMSI maybe also, but you know, OpenTTD not a lot of people do play. Really fun game. It is completely free as well. It's open source, so do feel free to look up that one on Google. It comes up straight away. It's great. Yep. Based off Transport Tycoon Deluxe, which did cost money back in the day. It's an old 90s game, and then in 2004 someone said, that game was fun, let's make an open source version of it, because you can, and it's been developed ever since. And it's just great. It's changed a lot over the years, but obviously since 2004 it has changed quite a lot, but it is really enjoyable when it's... I've been playing it most of... I played it most yesterday, and I'm making a whole map. Sort of completing it in sort of just every day. It was a 256x256 map. So if you played a game, you'd understand that one of the smallest map sizes in the game, other than smallest, 64x64, then 128x128, then 256x256. Obviously, I played that one, and it was fun just playing through that, completing it, walking it from my rail or bus or boat. I'm gonna go. Again, the brakes on this are really hard to get used to. Here we are approaching the rail station, 3.5 minutes late now, thanks to all of the traffic. Again, the route 203 actually comes through here. Is it 203? Or is it 205? Land into that 205. God blimey, we pulled right up to the edge on this one.
Do you do two-way tickets? Thanks, then.
I sure do. Yeah, you did. I've seen that. I'm a good driver like that. Go back for passengers. Come on, mate. We're already 4 minutes late. Hurry up. Lovely.
The next stop is Warren Avenue. This is the last stop on this.
Oh,
line.
Lovely! I forgot about that. So we pull into Daytonford rail station, and then obviously we head off to Warren Avenue non-stop. So there is a few stopping points on the way that you see. We go non-stop to Warren Avenue. We are currently running about 5 minutes late now, which is pretty crazy actually. The latest I must have ever been in OMSI, I think, unless intentional, like for like role playing. Something. So that's something I wanted to do. I wanted to try out like role playing or a challenge or something. There is a challenge you can do on both of them, so if that wants to start behaving and recording, then I might do that. And it's called the Herefield Challenge. So if you've ever played both of them, the area of Herefield, it's a village, so it's like really tight roads. The challenge is to drive a bendy bus around it with collisions on. Quite a challenge, to say the least, because the little bollards they use, they got like the weirdest freaking damage boxes in the world. Hit boxes in the world, so you sort of slam into them a little bit, like from sort of, you know, a good foot away or something. Some of them. So it is a real pain, but you can do it. It is possible. It just takes a lot of. Well, actually, not really supposed to do the bendy. It's any bus possible, any bus really. But basically, doing Herefield without crashing once while the collision's on. Obviously, I won't try and complete it. I mean, I could do, but that would mean a whole video on it. But see what we could do. So again, up here is a stop that does not include on this route. It's only on local routes. And Warren Avenue is not where the other routes. So most routes either terminate or go through Franklin Street, and not very many come up to Warren Avenue. It's a Daytran Express specific stop, if I remember rightly. There's a Macy's. Clear that way. So no cars decide to stop us to check how tight it is. Oh no, it goes pretty well. Good. So yeah. Yeah, I was just talking to my mum on the phone earlier, that's why I paused the video. Good news is I'm gonna be not that I have to ask for permission for trip like 17 on 118 in a few months. I mean, I was just specific because it is Mother's Day, but you know, I've recovered from my anxiety issues that I was having because of the events that happened, and gonna head out on this Saturday. So you'll probably already seen it, but this Saturday for me, gonna head out with a few other people for a day out, just film a compilation video of the full day. Don't know why the bus is doing this. Lock yourself in first gear for some reason. Yeah, so gonna do that and then head out with them and just film a compilation video. So it'll be the first time I do it. Probably a one-off style, or would have been a one-off style, so you may have already seen it. But yeah, come on, really late. Jesus Christ. Took its time. Blimey, fucking VW. What is this guy doing? Seriously. This is why I hate the AI on OMSI. This could be like a 7-minute delay on the end of this, seriously. Can't avoid traffic. Actually, if it's red, you can turn right anywhere into America. You gotta be careful on this bit because it's really hard to see one of the arrows. I'm gonna just skim across this kind of one of these cars. So if I remember rightly, there you go. You can just about see there's actually a turning just here. This is Warren Avenue, just around this bend. If you look, it's a express-only stop, so it's a special stop for the express routes. Let's get around here and I'll show you what I mean. We are very late, 6 minutes late. No, too late. No, you don't say. Okay, so we are already pulling off. Look at that. 4 minutes pulling off late, I think. Yeah. You start at 12 o'clock. I was supposed to be at Daytonford rail station already. That's insane. Yeah, so if you look at this stop, it's... actually, it's not spawned in, but when you get the scenery density up a bit higher, it's got like a official Daytran Express-only stop. It's aimed at connecting a link to this over here, which is the subway system, which obviously it's American, so it's above ground. And it actually does have a subway car that comes down if you look around enough. It does actually run. We have entered the abyss. There you go. Over there. And this runs around the whole map. As you can see, there's even little crossings on it. This is pretty cool, though. I think this is pretty nifty. I believe it uses modeling from, like, one of the German things. I don't know. That does look quite American. That reminds me a lot of GTA 4, where you could drive that. So, yeah. We'll ride that. So, yeah. Thank you all very much for watching my video here on OMSI 2 again. Today, we've been driving the Solaris Urbino 12. Here on Daytonford County. I'm going to just park up nicely for the thumbnail. Yeah, today we've been driving the Solaris Urbino 12 on Daytonford County on the Route 100 from Reymount to Daytonford. We've been, been a thoroughly enjoyable route. I do like this one quite a lot. So if you've liked what you've seen here today, then please feel free. So if you've enjoyed this, then feel free to like and subscribe. There is the other Route 100, the Route 101 that comes in here. So if you've liked what you've seen here today, then please feel free to like and subscribe. And remember, if you do subscribe, to hit that little bell so you get notified of my videos. Next video will be Scunthorpe Modern for OMSI 2. But, until then, I'll see you then. Until then, I've been JD the Train Spotter. This has been OMSI 2. Thank you for watching. Goodbye, everybody.